I called my sir. The hospital said it's full and no room for COVID patients. I think we have to quarantine. My boss said, you find a house for yourself. I terminated your contract because your madam said she's scared of the virus. Every day I need to buy my food. Every day I can't pay the boarding house. I have no work to pay for these. And I have family in the Philippines. I need to work. I feel so sad and so stressed. Every day my mama calls me, but I don't answer. I don't like to hear the voice. If I answer this one, I will cry again.
The government has to come into the picture. They cannot just leave it to Hong Kong families. No, these households are not ready. They do not have sufficient information. They don't know what to do. So their first tendency is to protect themselves. However close the migrant workers are to their employers, they are still considered as outsiders.
I think 9 employers have interviewed me. They always ask why your former employer terminated your contract. I told the truth. And then they always said, okay, bye, no need.
The police treat us like we are criminal. The stress is really onto us. The stress from work, stress from our employer, and then when we go out during our holiday, there's this police always harassing us. They treat us like we are the virus carrier, but that means we're just also a victim here.
But we have also very, very heartwarming stories where their employers actually provided them with room so they can isolate themselves. They are the ones cooking for them, really taking care of them. We have these stories as well.
I think after I finish my case, I can go back to the Philippines. I want to rest. For years, I didn't go back to the Philippines and see my daughter and my son. I miss them so much.